This tutorial shows how to test the residuals for normal distribution in a linear regression in SPSS. First, we need the residuals. Since residuals are the differences between the predicted and observed values of the dependent variable, the model must be calculated first. To do this, go to Analyze, Regression, Linear. The model is defined with a dependent and at least one independent variable. Then click the Save button and select Standardized under Residuals on the top right. Now the model is calculated, but we are not interested in the results. Instead, we want to examine the newly saved variable. You can see it in the variable view at the bottom or in the data view on the far right hand side. ZRE_1 are the residuals of the model I just defined and calculated. The test for normal distribution can be done in three ways, all accessed through the following dialog boxes: Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, Explore. Here we use the standardized residuals as the dependent variable. Under Plots, deselect Stem and Leaf, select Histogram, and additionally Normality Plots with Tests. Those settings are sufficient and we request the output. The first way to assess normality is by looking at skewness and kurtosis. A positive skew indicates a longer right tail, also described as a left-leaning curve. A negative skew stands for a longer left tail, or a right-leaning curve. Kurtosis corresponds to greater extremity of deviations. Some would call them outliers. The ratio of each to its standard error gives the Z value. You can compare the Z values with different critical values, 1.96, 2.58, or 3.92, depending on the confidence levels 0.05, 0.01, or 0.001 you aim to use. My skewness with a Z value of 2.43 is fine, however, my Z value of the kurtosis is a bit too high at 3.92, if we go by the ideal normal distribution. But we'll see that this is not too serious and that relying solely on numbers can be misleading, especially due to the fact that the standard errors will be smaller the larger your sample is, making the Z values larger. From personal experience, this method is not helpful for samples larger than 100. Let's turn to the second method that works with numbers, analytical tests. SPSS provides the Kolmogorov-Smirnov test and the Shapiro-Wilk test. Both assume normal distribution as the null hypothesis. Therefore, the alternative hypothesis is that there is no normal distribution. You can see that the tests give different results, which is unfortunate. The Kolmogorov-Smirnov test retains the null hypothesis, while the Shapiro-Wilk test rejects it. It is also important to note that as the sample size increases, even small, insignificant deviations from normality can lead to rejecting the null hypothesis. Not only does this increased sensitivity in large samples lead to unnecessary rejections of the null hypothesis, but both tests also lack power in small samples. In summary, both tests are unreliable and should not be used, which is repeatedly emphasized in the literature, for instance, field page 248. Finally, there's the third way: graphically check the residuals for normal distribution. SPSS provides, among other things, a histogram and a Q-Q-plot. The histogram should resemble some sort of bell curve, being symmetrical around the mean. However, a histogram can be manipulated quite easily. In my example, I can change the number of intervals in binning, for example, from 13 to 9, and make it look better. Because of the ease of manipulation, some reviewers reject histograms and prefer Q-Q-plots. In a Q-Q-plot, the line represents the perfect normal distribution, and the points represent the residuals. For perfectly normally distributed residuals, all points lie exactly on the line. Of course, this is not expected in reality, and the points lie more or less on or very close to the line to indicate normal distribution. Additionally, QQ plots will always have points in the upper right and lower left areas. These are the so-called long tails, which were already expected with the high kurtosis in my example, and were also visible in the histogram above. However, for large samples, we are usually fine with such a QQ plot. In my example, the point on the far right is indeed a bit far from the line, and I would consider this a borderline case. Usually, such a point indicates a case with high leverage. Why you should check for high leverage and how to diagnose such cases is shown in the following video.